Dear friend, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject internal combustion engine. This is lecture number 14, Problems in IC Engines. So we recap from the previous lecture. In the previous lecture, we studied about the testing of IC engine. We derived the equation for brake power, indicated power, brake specific fuel consumption, mechanical efficiency, brake thermal efficiency, indicated thermal efficiency, relative efficiency, and we have discussed about the heat balance test and the mass test. Now, in this lecture, so we will solve problems in the IC engine, and the topic here is problems in IC engine and learning outcome to the student. The student will be able to solve problem in IC engine at the end of the lecture. So, we take example number 1. So, from the Anna University question paper. So, all the problem whatever we solve here, it will be from Anna University question paper. The first question from the May 2006 question paper. The following data refer to a single cylinder 4-stroke petrol engine. Compression ratio is 5.6. Mechanical efficiency is 80%. Brake specific fuel consumption is 0.37 kilogram per kilowatt hour. Calorific value of the fuel is 44,000 kilojoules per kilogram. Adiabatic index of air equal to 1.4. Find the brake thermal efficiency, indicated thermal efficiency, air standard efficiency, and relative efficiency with respect to brake thermal efficiency. So we calculate all the parameters. First we write down the given data. It is a performance test. So, number of cylinder equal to 1, K equal to 1, 4-stroke engine, R compression ratio is 5.6, mechanical efficiency is 0.8, brake specific fuel consumption is 0.37 kilogram per kilowatt hour, calorific value of the fuel is 44,000 kilojoules per kilogram, and gamma equal to 1.4. First, we calculate the brake specific fuel consumption. So, from the brake specific fuel consumption is 0.37 kilogram per kilowatt hour, which is 0.37 by 3600, 1.03 into 10 power minus 4 kilogram per kilowatt second. And the brake thermal efficiency. So, the brake thermal efficiency is defined as brake power divided by mass of the fuel at the calorific value. Now, I take the brake power to the denominator. So, this will be 1 by mass of the fuel divided by the brake power into calorific value. And this ratio, mass of the fuel divided by brake power, it is what? Brake specific fuel consumption. So, BSFC into calorific value. So, substitute the value 1 divided by 1.03 in 10 power minus 4 into 44,000 equal to 0.22, which is 22%. So, the brake thermal efficiency is 22%. And the indicated thermal efficiency, the formula is IP by MF into CV. So, indicated power divided by mass of the fuel into calorific value. So, this is equal to, I take IP to the denominator. So, 1 divided by mass of fuel divided by the indicated power into calorific value. And in the denominator, I divide by brake power and multiply by brake power. So, mass of the fuel divided by the brake power into brake power by indicated power into CV. So, the first term, mass of the fuel divided by brake power is brake specific fuel consumption. And the brake power by indicated power is the mechanical efficiency into calorific value. So, BSFC is 1.03 in 10 power minus 4 into 0.8 into 44,000, which is 0.275 equal to 27.5%. So, indicated thermal efficiency equal to 27.5%. And the air standard efficiency for the petrol engine, it is working on the auto cycle. The efficiency of the auto cycle eta A equal to 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1, which is 1 minus 1 by 5.6 to the power 0.4 equal to 0.5, which is 50%. So, the air standard efficiency is 50%. And the relative efficiency with respect to the brake thermal efficiency. So, relative efficiency equal to brake thermal efficiency divided by the air standard efficiency, which is 0.22 divided by 0.5 equal to 0.44, which is 44%. And so these are all the answers. So relative efficiency, threshold brake thermal efficiency, air standard efficiency, indicated thermal efficiency, and we calculated the other parameter, brake specific brake thermal efficiency. So these are all the parameter that we have to calculate. So, breakthrough efficiency, integral thermal efficiency, air standard efficiency, relative efficiency. Now, example number 2. An 8-cylinder 4-stroke engine of 0.09 meter bore and 0.08 meter stroke with a compression ratio of 7 is tested at the 4500 RPM on a dynamometer which has 0.54 meter arm length. During a 10 minutes test, the dynamometer scale beam reading was 42 kg force and the engine consumed 4.4 kg of gasoline having calorific value 44,000 kilojoules per kilogram. The air is at 300 Kelvin and 1 bar was supplied to the carburetor at the rate of 6 kg per minute. Find the brake power delivered, brake mean effective pressure, brake specific fuel consumption, brake specific air consumption, brake thermal efficiency, volumetric efficiency and air fuel ratio. So, this is from the May 2009 question paper. So, we write down the given data. This is also performance test. K equal to 8, number of cylinder equal to 8, 4-stroke cycle engine, diameter of the piston is 0.04 meter, stroke length is 0.08 meter, compression ratio is 7, length of the brake arm 0.54 meter, time of the test is 10 minutes, this spring balance reading, spring scale reading is 42 kilogram force, which is equal to 412.02 Newton. So, kilogram force into Newton multiplied by 9.81. So, 412.02 Newton. Mass of the fuel is 4.4 kilogram. Calorific value is 44,000 kilojoules per kilogram. Temperature of the air is 300 Kelvin. Pressure of the air is 1 bar. And the mass of the air is 6 kilograms per minute. Now, we calculate the brake power delivered. So, first brake power. So, the brake power delivered BP equal to 2 pi N into W into L divided by 60. So, 2 pi into 4500. So, W is the load on the dynamometer. So, 412.02 Newton and L is the length of the brake arm. So, 0.54 meter divided by 60, which is 104.793 kilowatts. So, the brake power delivered is 104.793 kilowatts. Then, the brake mean effective pressure. So, mean effective pressure equal to BP by ALNK. So, brake power, A is the area of the cylinder, pi by 4 D square, L is the stroke length L, into N is the number of explosion for 4-stroke cycle engine, this is capital N divided by 2, and K is the number of cylinders. So, brake power, 104.793, pi by 4 into diameter is 0.09 square, stroke length is 0.08 meter, speed equal to 4500 RPM divided by 2, and the 60 to convert in seconds, revolutions per minute into revolutions per second, and 8 is the number of cylinders. So, calculating using the calculator, the brake mean effective pressure is 686.7 kilopascal. And the mass of the fuel consumed, so MF equal to 4.4 divided by 10 into 60. So, 4.5 kilogram of fuel is consumed in 10 minutes test. So, 4.4 divided by 10, that will give kilograms per minute, and divide by 60, that gives the kilograms per second. So, 4.4 divided by 10 into 60 equal to 7.33 into 10 power minus 3 kilograms per second. And the mass of the air consumed. So, it is given in the problem. Mass of the air consumed is 6 kilograms per minute is given. So, 6 divided by 60 equal to 0.1 kilograms per second. And the brake specific fuel consumption. So, the BSFC equal to mass of the fuel divided by the brake power. So, 7.33 into 10 power 3 minus 3 into 3600 divided by 104.793. is equal to 0.252 kilogram per kilowatt hour. So, the multiply by 3600 is to convert into kilogram per kilowatt hour. Then, brake specific air consumption. So, BSAC, that is mass of the air divided by the brake power, that indicates the amount of air, mass of the air consumed per kilowatt of power, brake specific air consumption. So, 0.1 into 3600 divided by 104.793 equal to 3.43 kilograms per kilowatt hour. And brake thermal efficiency is, so brake thermal efficiency is BP by mass of the fuel into calorific value. Substituting 104.793 divided by 7.33 in 10 power minus 3 into 44,000 equal to 0.325, which is 32.5%. and density of the air rho a equal to pa by r into ta from the perfect gas equation. So 100 divided by 0.287 into 300 equal to 1.16 kilograms per meter cube. And the volume of the theoretical air, so volume of theoretical air equal to volume of the cylinder pi by 4 d square into L into n by 60 for every for in the four stroke cycle engine, for every revolution there is one suction stroke. So n divided by 2 into 60 into number of cylinders. So calculating pi by 4 into 0.09 square into 0.08 into 4500 divided by 2 into 60 into 8 equal to 0.152 meter cube per second. So the theoretical volume of air is 0.152 meter cube per second. The actual volume of air, mass of air divided by density, so 0.1 divided by 1.16 equal to 0.0862 meter cube per second. And the volumetric efficiency is, so volume, actual volume of air VA divided by theoretical volume of air, so 0.0862 divided by 0.152 equal to 0.567, this is 56.7%. So volumetric efficiency of the engine is 56.7%, and the air fuel ratio AFR equal to mass of the air divided by mass of the fuel is 0.1 divided by 7.33 in 10 power minus 3 equal to 13.6. So we take the next problem, third problem. This is from the May 2009 question paper, Anna University. A single cylinder two-stroke SI engine working with a clearance volume 2.78 liters. The diameter and the stroke length of the cylinder are 200 mm and 300 mm respectively. The flow rate of fuel is 14 kilograms per hour, having the calorific value of 42,000 kilojoules per kilogram. The engine runs with a 680 rpm and the mean indicated effective pressure is 6 bar. Calculate the indicated power, indicated thermal efficiency, air standard efficiency and relative efficiency. So we write down the given data. So the two-stroke single cylinder engine, VC clearance volume is 2.78 liters, which is 2.78 in 10 power minus 3 meter cube. Diameter of the cylinder is 0.2 meter, stroke length is 0.3 meter. Mass of the fuel is 14 kilograms per hour, which is 3.9 into 10 power minus 3 kilograms per second. Calorific value equal to 42,000 kilojoules per kilogram. Speed equal to 680 rpm. And the indicator mean effective pressure is 6 bar equal to 600 kilopascal. So first we calculate the indicated power. So IP equal to PIM ALNK, which is PIM into pi by 4 d square L into NK. So for two stroke cycle engine, small n equal to capital N. Number of power strokes, there will be one power stroke in every revolution of the crankshaft. So small n equal to capital N. So IP equal to 600 into pi by 4 into 0.2 square into 0.3 into 680 divided by 60. So this 60 to convert the RPM into RPS in the number of cylinders equal to 1. So which is 64 kilowatts. So indicated power is 64 kilowatts. And the indicated thermal efficiency, IP by MF into CV, which is 64 divided by 3.89 in 10 power minus 3 into 42,000, which is 0.39 to 39.2%. Then the stroke volume, VS equal to pi by 4 d square into L. So pi by 4 into 0.2 square into 0.3 equal to 9.42 in 10 power minus 3 meter cube. And the compression ratio, R is given by VS plus VC divided by VC. So 9.42 10 power minus 3, VC is given in the problem 2.78 10 power minus 3 divided by 2.78 10 power minus 3 equal to 4.4, and the air standard efficiency is 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1 for petrol engine working on auto cycle. The auto cycle efficiency is 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1, which is 1 minus 1 by 4.4 to the power 0.4 equal to 0.447, which is 44.7%. Then the relative efficiency equal to indicated thermal efficiency divided by the air standard efficiency. So which is 0.392 divided by 0.447 equal to 0.877, which is 87.7%. Then we take the fourth problem from the Anna University question paper, May 2009. A two-stroke four-cylinder diesel engine running at 300 rpm produces 250 kilowatts of brake power. The cylinder dimensions are 30 cm bore and 25 cm stroke. The fuel consumption rate is 1 kg per minute, while the air fuel ratio is 10. The average indicated mean effective pressure is 0.8 MPa. determine the indicated power, mechanical efficiency, volumetric efficiency of the engine. Calorific fuel is 43 megajoules per kilogram. Ambient conditions are 1.013 bar and 27 degree Celsius. So, we write down the given data. This is again 2-stroke cycle engine performance test. Number of cylinder K equal to 4, speed equal to 300 rpm, brake power equal to 250 kilowatts, diameter of cylinder is 0.3 meter, stroke length is 0.25 meter, mass of the fuel is 1 kilograms per minute, air fuel ratio, mass of air divided by mass of fuel is 10, indicated mean effective pressure is 0.8 megapascal, which is 800 kilopascal, calorific value is 43 megajoules per kilogram, ambient air, temperature of the air, 27 degree Celsius, which is 300 Kelvin, and the pressure is 101.3 kilopascal. So, we calculate first indicated power. So, IP equal to PIM into ALNK. So, PIM into pi by 4 D square L into N divide N into K. So, PIM is 800 kilopascal into pi by 4 into 0.3 square into 0.25. Stroke length is 0.25 into speed equal to 300 divided by 60. So, the 60 is to convert the RPM into RPS into 4 cylinders into 4. So, IP equal to 282.6 kilowatts. And the mechanical efficiency of the engine, mechanical efficiency equal to BP by IP into 100, which is 250 divided by 282.6 into 100 equal to 88.4%. Density of the air equal to rho A equal to PA by R into TA from the perfect gas equation. So, 101.3 divided by 0.287 into 300 equal to 1.176 kilograms per meter cube. So, actual mass of the air, MA equal to MF into 10 because the air fuel ratio is 10. So, 1 into 10 equal to 10 kilograms per minute. Then the actual volume of the air, so VA equal to MA divided by rho A, mass of the air divided by the density of the air. So, 10 divided by 1.176 equal to 8.5 meter cube per minute. And theoretical volume of the air, so, V theoretical equal to pi by 4 D square L N into K, which is pi by 4 into 0.3 into 0.25, 0.3 square into 0.25 into 300 into 4 equal to 21.195 meter cube per minute. So, the speed we substitute only in minute to convert to get the value meter cube per minute. Now, the volumetric efficiency VA eta A equal to VA by V theoretical, which is 8.5 divided by 21.195 equal to 0.4. Which is 40%. So, the volumetric efficiency of the 2-stroke cycle engine is 40%. So, we stop here and these are all the reference books I used for preparing the slides. You can also refer to it. I have published a book on the subject, thermal engineering. So, you can refer to it for additional information or additional problems. You can refer to other ICE engine books for more information. So, thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box in the YouTube video. You subscribe the channel, subscribe my channel. So, I have published more than 200 videos on the thermal engineering subjects. And you can write to my mail ID for any clarification or WhatsApp to my number. I will sincerely answer to your queries. Thank you very much for watching and we will meet again with additional problems.